Hello everyone, this is Abhishek. Apple has finally released the 7th beta version of iOS 26 for registered developers. Along with it, Apple has also released the iPadOS 26 beta 7, watchOS 26 beta 7, macOS 26 beta 7, and tvOS 26 beta 7. Now let's talk about the update size and build version. The update is quite large, around 9.27 GB. Before this update, the build version was 23A5318F. And after the update, if you go to the general settings and then about on your iPhone, you will see the new build version is 23A5326A. The A at the end of the build version indicates that a final release is coming soon. We might see one or two more updates before the final public release. Alright, now let's talk about the storage and modem firmware. Before the update, the available storage was 199.07 GB and after the update, it increased to 210.74 GB. And let's talk about the modem firmware. The modem firmware remains unchanged at 2.04.06, both before and after the update. This means there were no changes to the modem firmware in this beta. Let's find out what's new and what changes are in iOS 26 beta 7. Frankly, there aren't any noticeable changes in this update. iOS 26 beta 7 is mainly for refinement and bug fixes to ensure a smooth public releases with no issues. However, I did find a new change in the battery settings. If you go to the battery and then power mode, you will see a new option, adaptive power. This feature was already available, but the new feature is adaptive power notifications. Now it notifies you when adaptive power is being used and optimizes background performance for better battery health or battery life. Alright, now let's talk about the performance. The overall performance is much better. The system-wide smoothness is noticeable and adding or customizing controls in the control center is very fluid. After the update, you will also see a new welcome screen that explains how the OS works. It shows off new animations, a new liquid glass UI, new controls, new camera controls, and a completely revamped camera screen. Bugs have been fixed everywhere. App loading and closing animations are much smoother and faster. So let's talk about the Geekbench score, which are slightly lower than the previous beta. Single core score is 3488. And the multi-core score is 8709. Earlier, before this update, the single core score was 3492 and the multi-core score was 8721 in iOS 26 beta 6. Despite the lower scores, the app opening and closing animations are very smooth. While the scores are slightly lower, the overall performance or user experience is much smoother. Now let's talk about the battery performance and heating issues. The best part about this update is that for the first time with an iOS 26 beta, I didn't experience any heating. This shows how stable this update is and is a good sign that the final release will be very stable and reliable. The battery performance is quite good. My battery health is still at 99% after 90 cycle counts. However, it is too early to make a final judgment on battery backup as it needs to be used more extensively. So these were all the updates for iOS 26 beta 7. I hope this video was helpful for you. If you want more videos like this, be sure to subscribe to Tech Review Pro channel.